Light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord. If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turn to night, darkness is not dark to you, O Lord. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike. Let us pray. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O gracious light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. This is a reading from Romans. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain its freedom of the glory of the children of God. Well, anything that is free from the bondage of decay will certainly have hope, but it also gives those difficult times in our lives, the times when we felt that we have had no hope, and I'm sure all of us have been through some kind of phase like that in this life of ours, because it's not subject to decay by the will of God, we know that we can move toward richness in the spirit, and that we really do have hope of our contribution to creation and to making it all a better place and to help make it pleasing in the sight of God. And if we can do that, we will each be lights of Christ this Advent season, and that will be a wonderful and blessed thing, because we will help to shine light onto a desperate and needy world so that no one need feel that their life is a life of decay, but rather that it's a life of promise, hope, peace, and love. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, creator of the changes of day and night, giving rest to the weary, renewing the strength of those who are spent, bestowing upon us occasions of song in the evening. You have protected us in the day that is past, so be with us in the coming night. Keep us from every sin, from every evil, and every fear, for you are our light and salvation and the strength of our life. To you be glory for endless ages. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Made up.